I welcome you all for today's design meet, ANA Digest design meet, decoding apartment design in today's urban fabric. Friends, as we all know, Pune and PCMC were known as villa towns or bungalow towns in the post-independence, when the Wada culture slowly converted, and in 70s, 80s, 90s also, early 90s, villas were coming up everywhere, bungalows. That time, prices started skyrocketing of plots, as we all know, and slowly the middle class couldn't afford bungalows anymore, and high rises started coming up everywhere. Earlier, the apartments were three-storied, two-storied, four-storied, and then suddenly the influx of apartments everywhere. I know I'm repeating what you already know, but this is the context of today's meet. And then it mushroomed everywhere. All these brands coming up with huge schemes. So today it's a known fact that apartment design is a very important design discipline for the fraternity also. Of course, at the same time, the expectations from the fraternity also increased multifold. The clients, your clients, they expect that their dream home be completed in the constraints of the budgets they give you and the limitations of the space of the exteriors in an apartment, and so many factors. People started preferring the security of an apartment. Apart from the high price of the plots, the security, the shared community spaces, the shared amenity spaces. So now it's a known fact. So now, in that context, today's design meet, we are meeting here with the help of experts to decode the correct design process of apartment design. So my first question to you is, what according to you is the ideal apartment?
Ideal apartment. See, basically ideal apartment is something which is suitable to the person who is going to occupy, meeting all his expectations and needs, and if he is happy, for him it is an ideal apartment, because the ideas, they change from person to person. So there is nothing, you cannot just put it in some frame that this is how the ideal apartment is called. So it's very difficult, because for somebody one bedroom, two bedroom apartment is also a dream house. Somebody duplex with 10,000, 20,000, that is also apartment. So there is nothing specific about it that it is a ideal apartment. Because even in our college, what they teach us is how to plan properly, whether it is a functional, whether it meets all the requirements of the clients, and if it works well, then it is an ideal apartment.
Sir, a rider of a question, what would be your, as an individual, ideal apartment?
For me, you are asking?
Yes, sir, personally. Just a rider of a question.
Knowing my nature and what I like, ideal apartment with lot of greenery around, which is very difficult nowadays. But I have that kind of apartment, a duplex with lot of garden area. So, if people can get that, I would say that is an ideal apartment.
Sir, there are basic fundamentals of design as a discipline. So, are there any thumb rules of apartment design as a discipline?
There are thumb rules how to design an apartment. But unfortunately, we come across with lot of apartments which are not properly designed. And my request to all my architect colleagues who are designing these apartments, so what should be the basic size of the bathroom, what should be the good size of the bedroom? Unfortunately, I hardly come across with well-designed apartments from the architects. And in that case, what happens, you have to do lot of changes. If same thing is done at the early stage, then you can save a lot of money and improvising the situation of that apartment. I have had these experiences so many times. But let me share one experience, or my very long, maybe 20-25 years back, when I had first visited Konark Estate, which was designed by opposite Pune College, designed by office contractor. And I think that was an ideal apartment. The reason being, everything was properly worked out. The placement of window, the placement of bed, the place for wardrobe, everything was so. I had no even chance, or I did not even think twice to. We need to change this. No, that is actually an ideal apartment. And we see a lot of apartments now where the cross entries are there from one end to another end. Just they are bothered about, I suppose, maximum FSI. And in that case, they forget what should be the correct layout. So in some cases, few of my clients, builders, so whenever they launch one project, so they always send me the drawing designed by their architect to see if everything is in right place. And I did it lot of those projects, those kind of things. And I must say thank you to Amit Builders, because I must have worked with them for on 10 projects even right now we are doing. So we try and put our inputs and try to make it ideal apartment.
Absolutely. And so many iconic buildings Amit Builders have come up with your guidance. Amazing, sir. Thank you so much for that. So, legendary architect Le Corbusier, he said once famously that architecture is a magnificent play of light and shadow. Now, this is pertaining to architecture and structures. Is this a challenge in apartment design? Like orchestrating natural light in that those constraints of exterior walls. Sometimes the plans are deep, the apartment plans are deep, or some people buy two apartments and join them and tell you that this is what we want. So at such times, the ducts may not be conveniently placed where the natural light can come in. Is it difficult for architects or designers to orchestrate natural light, which is so important?
Of course it is difficult, because if basically I was talking about the same thing, at the initial drawing stage, if you don't include all those aspects, then definitely what those great architects must have said, but it is very difficult to achieve that in today's context, because you are only worried about basic needs and maximum FSI. So you can't afford to give a lot of empty space to allow sunlight, more ventilation. So I hardly see that, unless it is a very high-end society where they are not worried about FSI, but they are worried about best planning. There you get ample of light, but it's very difficult to incorporate that. So though it's a very basic, fundamental, important issue. If you don't get good natural light, if you don't get good ventilation, and if you have to live on artificial light or artificial ventilation, that's not a life.
Very valid point, sir. So it all boils down to a builder who aims high and goes for a good architect, and from the root itself incorporates all the right elements, so that the interior designers or architects who design apartments in that get all the...
That is why I took Abhis Contractors name. Basically, probably he knows what's going to happen later on. So he must have incorporated everything at an early stage or inception stage. I think that kind of I had an opportunity to work in one or two projects designed by Chandrasekhar Kanitkar. So he always also thinks about that next designer who will come and he'll design that apartment, he should not disturb the walls and the windows, so that everything is properly nicely arranged. So, but everybody should do that. Actually, this is my humble request.
So then things will fall in place. So when a designer designs an average office, by average I mean a compact office or a average sized office or a retail space, he has to contend with one client, maybe a partner. But in apartments, the wife, the husband, the parents, the kids, sometimes the children, one is preteen, one is teen, and so on. So do you think that architects and interior designers also need to possess good oratory skills or convincing skills or interpersonal communication skills or like apart from having brilliant design skills, is this also important, especially in apartment design, getting your designs convinced?
I know that is one of the reasons few of my friends, they decided not to design apartments. The reason is you cannot satisfy everybody. And because the world has come close and internet and all that, they come and tell me, sir, can we make this
Pinterest?
No, not Pinterest. I remember one, it was from Amir Khan's picture. What was Three Idiots? And he showed me one chair. He said, this chair I want in my bedroom. So these kind of things, you know, they see somebody else's house and they want everything from every apartment. It is not possible. And then you keep on changing the designs. So I fully agree with you. It's very difficult task in spite of spending so many years in this profession, maybe 40 years. Even for today also, yeah, I can convince. But you come across with this kind of, and I have done lot of commercial places also, showrooms, and there you have to only one-to-one discussion happens and the things move very smoothly. Where in residential apartmenting sometimes it takes even 2 to 3 years, surprisingly, in which actually a 20-storied building can be erected. But one apartment takes 2 to 3 years. So it's but you can't help it. You can't change the nature.
Sir, you are architect Hari Agashe. You achieved everything. 40 years you have accolades, acclaimed architects. Clients look forward to do their projects with you. So for you, convincing, like it's been there, done that kind. But young designers, some are there in the audience today who do interior design of apartments and it's part of their repertoire, their portfolio. Do you think they should brush up on, I know this is not design related question, but I always see this. I've seen presentations where designers are showing drawings to a client and I've been there and I could see that. So do you think they should brush up on these skills?
First of all, if they are fresher, if they are coming out from the college or school, I strongly feel that they should, to achieve what you are expecting, to achieve that they should work under some architect for a reasonably good time. Like I spent almost 6 years under S.N. Singh's guidance, and so he's, of course he's no more, but at that time few of my friends, they had started their practice. I said, today I can afford to make mistakes because Singh sir is there to take care of it. But when I am on my own, I won't be able to afford these kind of mistakes. And when I thought now I am reasonably okay, then I left and I started. Meanwhile, I had gathered enough tactics how to handle client and all that, and then so the things were.
But sir, since I have known you since my wedding, like 26 years I know you, I've seen you're one of the most forthright person. I don't think you are diplomatic at all. That's my personal observation. You white is white and black is black. There are no grays when you speak. So in your young days, were you this way with the clients while approving the designs? Were you so forthright?
Not initially, yeah, I had to do a lot of compromise. But today, yes, I can say even Omkar knows about yesterday's issue. A client came, he had approved my entire bungalow plan. It is a architectural project. And he came yesterday and he asked me, because of Vastu guy, he suggests that bring the staircase on this side. I simply said, if you want to follow that, I will return my advance money and I won't work on this. So finally he said, okay, let's go ahead with your plan. But I said, if I am going to do that according to his whims and fancies, then later on what I am going to answer, if my friends come and visit that, of course I will be there. So I said, no, I can't, even I won't be able to tell anybody that this project is mine, I have designed this. But yeah, today I can afford to say all those things. Absolutely. But in those days, it was little difficult. But I did try my level best.
This was not planned, sir, but I just wanted to touch this. We can edit this from the film if you say so. You said you worked for 6 years with Singh, sir, 6.5 years. And that's a great thing to do even today. Even when we are invited at colleges and institutes, we implore the students to work. But I see a student who, from very poor families, and at 23 they pass out and become architects. After that, working for 5-6 years, and let's be honest, it's not very highly paid profession as a job, architecture or interior design. And then that is why sometimes, due to financial constraint, they want to start work immediately, maybe within a year, 6 months, 2 years, whatever. So though it's at such times, there's no answer, I know, it's just...
The answer is only you have to have patience. I know, it's if you want to achieve in long run, then you have to give some time, even if you are from poor family or whatever you are saying. But see, initially if you start immediately and if you make mistakes, who is going to pay for it? So ultimately it's going to be his or her loss. So it's better to work 3-4 years, maybe on a paltry amount or a not great salary, but at least meanwhile you will be ready to accept different challenges. So in spite of that situation, one should work. There is no option for that.
Right, sir. Thank you so much. Sir used to cycle for kilometers in 1980s to reach Singh sir's office. 80s, right, sir?
Yeah.
To reach Singh sir's office and used to work all those years. But sir, that generation was...
I think during that time, almost everybody had a similar situation. So, it's nothing great actually. Even my senior colleague, both of us used to cycle that route. So, that was a general situation.
Sir, you have been practicing successfully for 4 decades. And in the early part of your career, as I mentioned earlier, Pune and PCMC, they were bungalow towns. Like the bungalow culture was huge. And slowly it diminished, as I just mentioned in my prologue. You as an architect, when you do a bungalow, right now you mentioned yesterday you're doing a bungalow. You have, of course, albeit fulfilling the functional aspect of the clients, you have some scope of experimenting with the structure. I understand form follows function, but once the function is satisfied, you can express yourself. If the client is giving you freedom and budget is there in the form, the structure, the build, this thing. But in apartments, it's a constricted space. It's already a defined parameters for you. So do you personally feel as an architect constricted during apartment design compared to villa design?
Obviously, you are given certain frame with locations of windows and doors and all that. The best way to achieve, I don't think suppose we can do it in a bungalows, but apartment with lot of constraints is very difficult to achieve. But however, all those things, constraints, one should try and give justice to the space, what is available, try and give them very workable plan and easy to maintain. And whatever sources available there, you can experiment with material, definitely different finishes, but that much only you can do if it is a small apartment. And if it is big and budget is good, then you can do lot of experiments. But in a certain restricted area. Basic plan is very difficult to change.
So before we end this part, and then we'll be having a presentation by Omkar and Poonam, and then we'll be inviting you back for the question answer session with the audience. One last question. Your advice for everybody in the audience and the fraternity at large. I will not specify whether the advice should be on the topic of apartment, which is today, or an advice, a general advice for professional excellence for everybody. That's your choice. But we would not love to, we would love to have that your wisdom from you.
See, apart from my age, I don't think I am in a position to advise anybody. But what I am practicing, that you should be loyal to your project, be honest to your project, and try and give as much as possible from bottom of your heart, so that I know the journey is long to achieve, but in all this, try to be very honest. In one word, you have to be honest with your design, and you have to be very honest with your client, and the success is always there.
Fantastic, sir. On that note, we end this part of the session. Thank you so much.
Me too. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Friends, now we shall witness a presentation, as I mentioned earlier, by Principal Architects of Studio OHA, Architect Omkar Agashe and Architect Poonam Sardesai. So this is a 5-bedroom apartment made in Pune, created by them.
Hi, good evening everyone. I would like to thank Amit sir and Monica ma'am of A&I Digest for giving us this opportunity to present this project, which is very close to our hearts. It is a 5 BHK home, and we were approached to design this project for the very exciting couple, their 3 daughters, Amit sir's father, and lots of pets. How this happened, how we were approached, is a very sort of interesting story, which Omkar will tell us about.
Namaskar. So 2016 madhe ami ek khup chhan studio design kela hota, Kavita Koparkar Bridal Studio. Ani sarancha ekda phone ala ani te mhanle, I want to cover it in my next issue. So me so and so time lai, so you and Poonam be there. And so they perfect as usual, they tencha perfect time la ale aat ale aur tenni tencha mobile off kela ani recorder kadla ani mhanle ki ata mi kay lihnar nahi, karan it just it wastes a lot of time. So you start speaking on my mi je prashna vicharen tyachyavar vage. So to interview suru zala, sarani lots of question vicharle ani bolta bolta I don't know what happened, tenni madhes recorder off kela. आणि ते म्हणले ऑफ द रेकॉर्ड मला काही प्रश्न विचारायचे आहेत, कारण मला पुढच्या इश्यूमध्ये अपार्टमेंट डिझाईनचा कन्सेप्ट घ्यायचा आहे. वी आर लाईक ओके, विचारा काय विचारायचं ते. सो ही स्टार्टेड आस्किंग लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चन्स रिलेटेड टू अपार्टमेंट डिझाईन. मग त्यांनी परत रेकॉर्डर ऑन केला आणि आमचा ब्रायडल स्टुडिओचा हे जे काय कव्हर करायचं होतं ते सगळं संपवलं, परत त्यांचा रेकॉर्डर ऑफ केला. And he kept on asking lot of questions related to apartment design, very generic questions. मैं असं काही काय म्हणजे क्लायंट नीड्स कसे असतात. मी आता सर हरी सरांचा जसा इंटरव्ह्यू झाला, थोडासा लोअर लेवलमध्ये आमचा घेतला होता सरांनी. सो फाईन, सो सर गेले. मग आफ्टर फ्यू डेज ही कॉल्ड अँड ही सेड, अरे ते अपार्टमेंट डिझाईनचं नेक्स्ट इश्यूचं माझ्या डोक्यात खूप बसलं आहे, आय वॉन्ट टू कम अगेन अँड ईट युअर ब्रेन्स ऑन दॅट. सो पण पूनमला पण सांग परत यायला, कारण मला दोघांना प्रश्न विचार. सो वी वर वेटिंग फॉर हिम अगेन, ही केम ऑन टाईम, बट दिस टाईम मोनिका मॅम वॉज विथ हिम अँड दे एंटर्ड आर कॉन्फरन्स रूम अँड ओपन द ब्रोशर अँड केप्ट इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस अँड ही सेड की हे दोन आता अपार्टमेंट्स आहेत, हे आम्ही घेतले आहेत आणि तुम्हाला डिझाईन करायचे आहेत. अँड युअर शॉक्ड अँड सरप्राईज. शॉक्ड बिकॉज
ती ऑडिशन होती बेसिकली आमची, आम्हाला नंतर
कळलं. फर्स्ट आय थॉट की ही इज जोकिंग, कारण मी त्यांना विचारलं तुम्हाला वरती केबिन मध्ये जायचं आहे का, पप्पांच्या इथे का, यू जस्ट वॉन्ट टू गो थ्रू अस राईट नाव अँड देन आस्क हिम लेटर. नाही नाही नाही, मला तुम्हालाच द्यायचं आहे. थोडस वी थॉट की अरे आम्ही जस्ट 5-6 इयर्स फील्ड मध्ये येऊन झालंय अँड व्हॉट डिड यू सी अँड ही ऑफकोर्स ही स्टार्टेड यु नो टेलिंग की काय म्हणजे आमची स्टाईल आवडते अँड व्हॉट एव्हर सो वी फेल्ट व्हेरी प्राऊड अँड व्हेरी ऑनर्ड बेसिकली की सरांनी आम्हाला अप्रोच केलं हिम बिईंग इन दिस फील्ड फॉर सो मेनी इयर्स ऑलरेडी सो बालेवाडीला सरांनी ते दोन अपार्टमेंट्स घेतले होते ऑन द लेफ्ट यू कॅन सी देअर इज अ 3 BHK अँड ऑन द राईट देअर इज अ 2 BHK अँड ही टोल्ड अस की मला नंबर ऑफ रूम्स रिटेन करायचं आहे माय फॅमिली स्ट्रक्चर इज सच दॅट आय डोंट वॉन्ट टू चेंज दॅट अँड आय ऑल्सो डोंट वॉन्ट की ते दोन अपार्टमेंट्स जॉईन केलेत असं फिलिंग पण नको आहे सो वी स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग की काय हाऊ टू यु नो अप्रोच अँड सो टिपिकली वॉट वी डू इज आफ्टर अ फ्यू क्वेश्चनर त्यांचं म्हणजे ऑफकोर्स काय रिक्वायरमेंट आहे आणि फॅमिली स्ट्रक्चर काय आहे कोणाची काय आवड निवड आहे करून आम्ही वी डिसायडेड टू ऑफकोर्स आम्ही 5-6 ऑप्शन्स पण केले होते सरांसाठी अँड वी फायनली क्रोज दिस ऑप्शन अँड सरांचे काही काही टिपिकल म्हणजे व्हेरी स्पेसिफिक रिक्वायरमेंट होते ते म्हणजे की कॉमन एरियाज मोठ्या पाहिजेत बिकॉज ही लाईक्स टू होस्ट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल इयर राऊंड सो अ बिग हॉल ही वॉन्टेड अ बिग बार ऑल्सो अँड कॉमन एरियाजमध्ये ही सर म्हणाले की आम्हाला ऑफकोर्स ॲज अ फॅमिली मूवीज बघायला आवडतात सो काही काही ज्या गोष्टी होत्या त्या त्यांना हव्या होत्या होम थिएटर हवंच होतं सो वी ट्राईड लॉट ऑफ ऑप्शन्स की होम थिएटर कंबाईन करायचं का लिव्हिंग रूम बरोबर पण असं करत करत फायनली वी केम टू दिस वी फ्रोज दिस सो यू हॅव अ नाईस लॉबी हिअर थँकफुली सरांनी दोन्ही अपार्टमेंट्स घेतल्यामुळे इट वॉज नाईस ऑन द बिल्डर्स पार्ट की आम्हाला ही बाहेरची लॉबी वापरायला मिळाली सो यू एंटर इन टू अनदर लॉबी इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ अ ट्रान्झिशनल स्पेस हिअर ड्यू टू सर्व्हिसेस रिस्ट्रिक्शन्स वी हॅड टू हॅव अ किचन हिअर अँड आम्हाला ते एक्सपोज पण करायचं नव्हतं सो वी हॅड अ पार्टिशन वी डिझाईन द एंटायर किचन अलॉंग विथ द युटिलिटी बट ऑब्विसली किचनच्या बाजूला डायनिंग एरिया आली डायनिंग एरिया थोडी आत येत होती म्हणून आम्ही जे हे होम थिएटर केलंय इथे यू हॅव टू लार्ज विंडोज वी हॅव गिवन लॉट्स ऑफ ग्लास ओव्हर हिअर सो वेन एव्हर द होम थिएटर इज नॉट इन यूज दे कॅन ओपन द कर्टन्स अँड लेट द नॅचरल लाईट परकोलेट राईट इन टू द डायनिंग एरिया सो बेसिकली बिकॉज इट्स दे आर टू अपार्टमेंट्स दे आर डिवायडेड टू टू झोन्स सो कॉमन एरियाज कम हिअर यू गो इन टू दिस झोन इथे त्यांच्या धाकट्या मुली आहेत ज्या ट्विन्स आहेत त्या दोघींच्या आवडी बऱ्याचशा सिमिलर असून त्यांच्या बऱ्याचशा गोष्टी वेगळ्या पण सो वी हॅड टू यु नो डिझाईन टू डिस्टिंक स्पेसेस हिअर यू हॅव अ स्टोरेज हिअर स्टोरूम हिअर सरांची एक स्पेसिफिक रिक्वायरमेंट होती आम्हाला पहिले वाटलं की सरांना आपण आतमध्ये मास्टर बेडरूम देऊयात पण सर म्हणाले की नाही मला एंट्रन्सच्या सर्वात जवळची रूम लागते ॲज अ मास्टर बेडरूम सो ऑब्विसली मास्टर बेडरूमचं लोकेशन हे फिक्स झालं पूर्वी एंट्री इकडे होती आणि मगाशी जसे हरी सर म्हणाले की यु नो दे हॅड अ क्रॉस प्लॅनिंग म्हणजे इथे एंट्री आणि इथे टॉयलेट डोअर सो काही फंक्शन नीट बसत नव्हतं सो वी डीड लॉट ऑफ सिव्हिल चेंजेस बट दिस वॉज वन ऑफ द व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट वन आम्ही ऑल दो अक्रॉस द टी व्ही येत आहे बट वी थॉट की दिस मुवमेंट इज मच इझियर सरांच्या रिक्वायरमेंट प्रमाणे नाईस बार सेटअप यू हॅव अ लिव्हिंग रूम सरांच्या वडिलांची खोली अँड देअर एल्डर डॉटर सो दिस इज द बेसिक प्लॅनिंग अँड जेव्हा मी स्टार्ट केलं प्लॅनिंग करायला आणि मी आणि पूनम बरेच डिस्कशन करत होतो सरांशी पण बोललो आणि सर म्हणाले की मला कमीत कमी गोष्टी विकत आणायच्या सो आम्हाला खूप ॲज फार ॲज पॉसिबल सगळं कस्टमाईज करून द्या सो ॲज यू कॅन सी ऑल द फिक्स्ड फर्निचर विच वी हॅव डन इज डिझाईन बाय अस ओनली द येल्लो थिंग्स आर बॉट फ्यू थिंग्स ही हॅड ऑलरेडी गॉट अँड लॉट ऑफ प्रॉडक्ट्स विच वर डिझाईन फ्यू ऑफ देम आर पार्ट ऑफ द फर्निचर बट अ लॉट ऑफ देम वर द लाईट फिटिंग्स अँड बार चेअर्स तुम्हाला पुढे पुढच्या स्लाइड्समध्ये कळेल मग बोलता बोलता असं आम्हाला लक्षात आलं की म्हणजे ॲज द दिस थिंग प्रोग्रेस्ड आर डिस्कशन्स की खूप डिस्टिंक्ट पर्सनॅलिटीज आहेत त्यांच्या घरामध्ये. सरांना एक स्पेसिफिक टाईपचं हाऊस हवं होतं, मॅमला एक स्पेसिफिक टाईपचं हाऊस हवं होतं, देअर होम. सो सरांना खूपशा गोष्टी त्यांच्या आठवणींपासून हव्या होत्या. म्हणजे ही स्टेड इन गोवा, ही स्टेड इन लोणावळा. सो त्यांना एकदम रस्टिक लुकिंग घर हवं होतं, विथ एंटायर हाऊस इन कोटा फ्लोरिंग आणि मग लॉट्स ऑफ टेराकोटा नॅचरल फर्निचर. आणि मॅम आणि मुलींशी बोलून आम्हाला लक्षात आलं की त्यांना असं बऱ्यापैकी ग्लॅमरस हाऊस हवं होतं, बिकॉज they wanted to be like part of that Balewadi High Street since it's in the vicinity. So आम्ही बोलता बोलता असं फायनली सरांनाही थोडं कन्व्हिन्स करत होतो, मॅमलाही थोडं कन्व्हिन्स करत होतं की थोडा पण डी ग्लॅम या पॉईंटला जाऊ. सरांना म्हणलं नाही, आपल्याला थोडंसं काही गोष्टी ग्लॅमरस करायच्या. सो पॅलेट आम्ही ठरवताना असं ठरवलं की विल डू अ लॉट्स ऑफ बॅलन्सिंग ॲक्ट. म्हणजे रस्टिक एलिमेंट्स पण घ्यायचे, पण त्याच्याबरोबर त्याला ऑफसेट करायला ग्लॅमर एलिमेंट्स करायचे आणि वाईस वर्सा. सो वी केम अप विथ अ पॅलेट. ऑफकोर्स पुढे स्लाइड्समध्ये कळेल. सो देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ एलिमेंट्स विच आर रस्टिक अलॉंग विथ लॉट ऑफ ग्लॅमर एलिमेंट्स. कस्टमायझेशन वॉज अ बिग पार्ट. सो यू कॅन सी आम्ही खूप ड्रॉइंग्स केले यांच्या एंटायर, म्हणजे राईट फ्रॉम नॉट जस्ट एलिव्हेशन्स, वी डीड लॉट ऑफ वर्किंग ड्रॉइंग्स अँड वर्किंग ड्रॉइंग्स टू मायन्यूट डिटेल्स. म्हणजे नॉट जस्ट दीज, हे तर आपलं रेग्युलर आहे, सगळे डिझायनर्स करतात, बट वी डीड लॉट ऑफ कस्टमायझेशन ऑन फर्निचर पार्ट. साईड टेबल्स डिझाईन केले, बार डिझाईन केला, व्हेरी युनिक बार ऑफकोर्स, त्याच्याबद्दल पुढे पूनम सांगेल. राईट फ्रॉम मिरर्स, everything was customized, a few of the drawings. A typical section dakhavla hai to show the scale of the entire house. Again the bar chair, so lobby madhe ami वरांड्याचा फील द्यायचा, म्हणजे टेकिंग फ्रॉम गोवन आर्किटेक्चर आम्ही वरांड्याचा फील द्यायचा प्रयत्न केला आहे. इथे नॅचरल स्टोन लुकिंग टाईल्समध्ये आम्ही थोडासा प्ले केलेला आहे. या टाईल्स खूप सुंदर आहेत, दीज वर इम्पोर्टेड आय गेस, अँड अमेझिंग त्याला टेक्स्चरल क्वालिटी आहे. लॉट्स ऑफ नॅचरल व्हेरिएशन इन देम. आणि त्यांनी खूप, how to say it in right words, it was a standout element in the entire house. You have lobby, lobby itna ek atli second lobby diste, behind this partition you have the kitchen. So kitchen expose hot nahi lagecha, even if it's right in front of the door. And you have a very typical element of Tulsi Vrindavan, mage Ganpati statue and ha jhula ami design kela to give the rustic feel. And this is the point from jikade tumhi enter keliyavar lagech, you know, you have all these glam elements. Hi dining table ami design kela. The table top is made up of mango wood, being mango tree being a very essence of Konkan region. So this was a beautiful dining table which we did. त्याच्यात तो एक रस्टिक फील पण आहे, त्याला एक नॅचरल टेक्स्चरल क्वालिटी ठेवली आहे, पण फार अंड्युलेशन नाही ठेवले, सो दॅट इट इज इझी टू मेंटेन ऑल्सो. यू कॅन हॅव अ ग्लिम्स ऑफ किचन फ्रॉम हिअर, व्हेरी इझी ॲक्सेस फ्रॉम डायनिंग टू किचन. आर्ट डेको स्टाईलमध्ये वी हॅव रॅप्ड अप द एंटायर किचन. फ्यू मोर अँगल्स ऑफ द सेम dining area. You can see the home theater. We have lots of glass here. Amala te doubly glazed glass ghela lagla because of the for the acoustical treatment. Saranjo home theater. Ithe actually sagya family la tyanche individual म्हणजे एक्सपेक्टेशन्स होत्या. सरांना इथे खूप रीडिंग करायचं होतं. देअर डॉटर बिंग अ डिरेक्टर, दिस वॉज लाईक अ स्टडी रूम फॉर अर अँड नॉट जस्ट एंटरटेनमेंट. सो होम थिएटरला आम्ही ते ड्रॉप डाउन प्रोजेक्टर स्क्रीन घेऊन सरांची लायब्ररी पण बसवली अँड वी कुड फिट इन द प्रोजेक्टर ऑल्सो. दिस इज हाउ इट इज होम थिएटर फ्रॉम अनदर अँगल. Poonam can take over now.
So as Omkar has mentioned, sir has a set of twins. Both are artists. One is into commercial art and one is into the digital medium. They have super distinct personalities, and I think that was one of the challenges we faced in this project, is that each room, and sir was actually very insistent that this is their dream home, everyone's dream home, and it has to be customized for each of its inhabitants. So we had the conviction that both these rooms had to be similar in their ideology but had to stand out and be very different from each other. So we found this very nice pre-polished veneer. One was this shade of blue, which we chose for their daughter who does painting on canvas, and the other one, which we'll see in the next slide, was gray. We've also used a lot of mirror to sort of, as sir was discussing earlier, the room sizes as compared to the open areas are a little restrictive. So to try and not have all the wardrobe sort of come onto you, we've used a lot of mirrors. All the beds, everything that you've seen has been custom designed from the mirror frames. We've carried the same concept into the bathrooms also. So I'm not sure if theme is the right word, but whatever we've designed for the bedroom has sort of carried into the bathrooms. So this is the other daughter's room. So we felt her personality is like very outgoing and exuberant and rugged. So we've used a lot of metal, leather, concrete, where the earlier one where we had used exposed brick cladding, which was a very soft sort of cladding, and here we've gone in for concrete panels. And all of this, like as Omkar has shown you earlier, all the side tables, the bed, everything was designed and fabricated and customized for some. This was the parents' bedroom. We were very glad we had the opportunity to meet Amit sir's father. He was defying his age, and he was super enthused and excited about how his room is going to be. And earlier we had planned like a very sober sort of room, but then we thought that his personality deserved this very lively sort of room. So we brought in this copper and brass elements, and we went in for this back paneling. A very nice veneer was also chosen for his wardrobes. So very warm and cozy person, and we thought that the interior of the room should reflect that. And this is the master bedroom. So for this, our primary idea was to give a four-poster bed. We thought that that sort of goes with the dynamics of the couple. Again, we thought that let's deconstruct the four-poster bed, so it doesn't have the four posters, it has two posters and a sort of canopy that projects. Because we've used a lot of veneer, we've tried to offset those dark tones of wood with white duco paint for the bed, the paneling, and all these mirrors again were designed and cut. A very nice detail here is that these mirror frames, they open, and there is a lot of storage that goes behind these mirrors. This is one of our favorite rooms in the house. It is for their elder daughter. She's a director. Again, like everyone in the house, she has a very strong, distinct personality. And one very nice quality we found about her is that she's very direct and outright, and there's no like gray sort of in her personality, very black and white. And we thought that why not, like, you know, going for a Parisian theme for her room. So there's black and white and lots of use of gray in the mirrors. And once you speak to her, you realize that she is sort of a very soft person at heart. So we tried to bring that through the beige and the tones in the carpet and the soft furnishings, the bed back. All of that softness has been actually brought in through the soft furnishing. A touch of rose gold has been used in the handles to glam up the room, and considering it was the Paris vibe that we were going for, we put in a chandelier. Yeah, again the bed backs, side tables, the mirror frames, everything has been designed as per the inhabitants. The same theme of black and white was taken through into her bathroom. And this is the living room. So once you enter the lobby, to the right is the dining and the home theater. Right in front of the entry is the kitchen. So we've wrapped it all around with Art Deco paneling, and we thought this is like a nice point where you enter into the house, you can see yourself, or when you're stepping out there's a mirror, you can take a picture. So this is one nice like sort of area that we thought we've detailed out. And this is the living room. We've gone with a scheme of blue in the soft furnishing. These curtains were designed by Mansi Badve ma'am, and she has gotten a trickle of leaves and shimmer into the curtains. The center table was also, I think, custom designed. They, as a family, they're pretty easygoing, and there is not like this very fastidious or hard and fast, these are rules and you have to follow. So we tried to bring that seamlessness in their attitude also within the home. So all the flooring, so there is no particular inside outside, so the flooring has been brought in. And once you step out, this now, whenever we've met Amit sir and Monica ma'am, we've always met them here. This has become like a favorite spot. And this bar was designed as with a gabion wall concept. We thought that there needs to be some shocking drama in this bar. So we've given a cobalt blue, like a bright electric blue to the fabrication. There's a pine wood top, and these chairs again have been designed by Omkar, and even the outdoor seating chairs and these bar chairs. And they sort of, I think, like they bring out like this very fun and naughty element that is there within the family and the vibe that is there. And we assume we've been able to touch upon that. And considering like whatever they have these very intimate celebrations, and they are always up for celebrating all the small events in their life also. All birthdays, everything, any achievement, everything happens here, and we are quite proud that we've been able to give them a backdrop, you know, for all of that happiness that happens in this home. So even now ma'am keep sending us videos, like for Diwali this is how we've set it up, and for Christmas this is what we've done. So I think for us that is a very good feeling, when still they are responding in a very nice positive way with the home. So yes, considering there were a lot of different things to do in every room, we had to do a lot of layering, lots of different materials which were put together, and we thought this was a very good attempt at we thought it shouldn't even feel like one person has designed one room, the other person has designed the other room. So we also tried that all of the spaces should work together cohesively. So I feel we have achieved that. And again, we'd like to thank both of you for trusting us with your home, and again inviting us here to present this project. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone.
What is your overwhelming emotion about this project?
You both and your family. It is, as Omkar said, so early on in your career to get a project like this from someone actually like you, who knows almost like all the designers in town, and still, like you said, you had that gut feeling about us to go with it. And every time it was always there at the back of our mind. It still always is, that the trust that has been put in us, you know, we have to never fall short of it and deliver more than that was expected. So I think it still is an overwhelming feeling to even present it now.
Thank you. What has your architecture and design of the home brought to your client's life?
think lots of time we got a feedback from our client that the architecture of the house, I won't call it apartment anymore. So their home has enhanced their life, and that's something, you know, you are aiming to finally achieve through your design, that the end user is going from point A to point B, and that journey is a positive one. So that is something which we have always got through the client's feedback.
Excellent. This is a personal question. What's your favorite thing about this project? I'll start with Poonam. So you designed this for the client, the clients are living there and they have their own favorite things. What's your favorite thing?
My favorite thing about this project is that there are a lot of projects where I go back in my mind and I think that this I could have done differently. But in this home, there is nothing that I feel we could have done differently. And I think that is my favorite feeling about this project.
There are two aspects here. There's a favorite space. I think the bar is my favorite space over there, not just because it's a bar, but it really gives a good vibe. And one aspect which I feel that is very dear to me is that I got to learn a lot of things and lot of insights from the client, because he had lots of wisdom regarding the design and overall approach. The client was very clear as to how the end house or the end design would be, and that helped us a lot. And we got to experiment a lot because there were no constraints from the client. The client was very clear that whatever you design, we would be happy anyway. So that is a big responsibility, as well as a very joyous moment, because you want to experiment a lot. Here we got to learn a lot about new elements as well, because since it was just 5 years, we were still in the learning. We still are, but we got to learn a lot of new elements, because the client would take us to a lot of different showrooms for us to explore. The client never said that I want this or I want this material, but by just doing the entire research, we got to learn a lot about different materials which were there in the market at that time. So that is one of the most rather favorite point of learning for me.
Thank you for being so candid. So now that she has already eaten on this question, so I'm going to come to you straight up. It is ready 3.5 years ago, your client shifted in and they're using it and all. On hindsight, is there anything honestly that you feel should have been changed, or you want to change something?
I wouldn't change anything as such, but I would prefer to use more laminates here instead of veneers, because I think with having so many pets, it's bound to, you know, the veneer is going to get disturbed, and the pets are the way they are. I mean, however much you would like them to, you know, behave in certain manner, they are not going to do that. And I think, of course, we had discussed this, that we'll go with laminates. Of course, the veneers give a different effect altogether, but I still feel that if it would have been my house, I would have strongly advised with going with the laminates.
Okay, to be fair with you both, the dogs were going to be restricted behind the glass door in the twins' rooms, which slowly we gave up. The glass door we removed, and the dogs go everywhere.
That's what is expected if you want to have, because they are part of family.
Yeah, and
ask them to, you know, be in certain rooms.
These veneers give us a passage of time. The scratches in it, the everything, it's passage of time for us. So we don't regret at all. At all.
Okay. So do you want us to ask you that question? Is there anything we should have changed?
Okay. A very cliche question which generally comes in presentations, but very important for in this context. What was the biggest challenge for you in this project? Y'all can both answer separately if y'all both face separate challenges.
For me, I was just actually thinking about that. The biggest challenge was you came to us with a vision of making it very rustic and traditional and all of that. And Omkar very nicely went ahead and said, no, no, sir, this notion is not correct. We have to do something which is contemporary. And I remember I told Omkar ki bapre, why did you go and promise this to sir? Now we have to really follow up on our word. So I think ki, to do that was a big challenge. Ki we had now already convinced you ki don't go like the traditional way, vernacular way. So I think to follow up on that was challenging.
So architect in me would say the grid was a big challenge. Lots of beams were there, and that was, we had to mitigate a lot of this grid, and since we had removed the entire central part with the demolishing of all the walls, the grids being exposed, it was a big challenge to have the false ceiling designed in such a way that it doesn't come too low, but the beams also not very intrusive. So as a very practical aspect from the project, I think this was a very challenging thing.
I also heard in the grapevine that the wife was very difficult for you all to handle. She was too...
It was not at all difficult. The client's wife had certain dreams about a certain aspects, and there were few things which we couldn't change because of the nature of the apartment, because as you were also Hari sir was explaining, there are certain things you cannot change, but thankfully ma'am was very easy to convince, and I think you did very well by asking us to convince her of few things which you couldn't do it.
Did your clients interfere a lot with your work? I heard, as I said, that the lady was difficult, so that way, was it difficult? Because many designers...
I'm not going to agree to this. What he wants us to say, we are never going to agree.
No, many designers face very difficult clients.
Yes. So, the most difficult part was to bring the client to the site, because both of them were not ready to come on site till the entire thing was completed, and that part of dealing with the client was very difficult, because normally and very naturally the clients want to see the entire progress, but we were told that no, we just want to see the end product, but it doesn't work that way. And so at certain important junctions, we had to bring in the client and to choose a lot of materials as well as coming on site to see how the progress is going.
See, I've been with designers for 25 years, and I've seen this, that the client, while selecting the architect or designer, you do your process, research. Once you select, give the keys to the architects, give the budget and even some flexibility in the budget. You can't just be obstinate and then just leave it. Let them complete the project, go be surprised at the end. And that's what we felt we should, but they insisted during the curtain stage and certain fabric stage. And she used to tell me, Jai, let's go.
Yeah, actually fun to go and do all those selections.
Okay, somewhat philosophical, oblique, surreal question. How close are you with the finished project to your initial plan design? It's not at all philosophical. Okay, I'll repeat.
I could have, if this question was known, I could have shown the views. And I think we have been able to achieve more than 90% likeness to the views. Of course, there were things which naturally changed due to selection of few materials, but If I was to show the elder daughter's bedroom right now, the visuals as well as the real photo, it would be very hard to tell the difference. And same goes with most of the spaces in the house. So I think we achieved what we had started over the, even with 7-8 months which the project was going on, we did not change a lot So I think we are very happy with the result.
So what does this house deliver? What are the great moments of this house?
I think after all these years also you've still thought of us and invited us to present. I think that in a very positive way we have been in your mind thanks to the house. And I think that's the best. Like in the end no one is going to ask ki, as you said, काय खर्च झाला, किती दिवस लागले, काय मध्ये स्ट्रगल झालं ते फक्त आपल्याला माहिती आहे. बट स्टील ऑल ऑफ अस हॅव कम आउट ऑफ इट विथ अ व्हेरी पॉझिटिव्ह अँड हॅपी रॅपो अँड रिलेशन, अँड यू स्टील वॉन्ट अस टू कम अँड प्रेझेंट इट. सो आय थिंक दॅट्स द बेस्ट एनिथिंग कुड आस्क फॉर, अँड ऑल्सो द अदर प्रोजेक्ट्स इन द पाइपलाइन.
ऑन द रेकॉर्ड दिस इज अवर फर्स्ट प्रेझेंटेशन ऑफ एनी ऑफ अवर प्रोजेक्ट्स. इज इट? Yeah, so this is our first presentation.
And on the record, I don't remember any struggle we had. Whatever struggle must be between them both.
Sir, some drama we have to add.
struggle,
on the record, I have to be trouble.
How close it is, according to you, to your client's dream home, honestly?
What I really feel is we have gone beyond expectations that were set is what I perceive. It is your dream home. I feel we've delivered on that account.
Absolutely. At the cost of sounding gushy, we are totally happy, and that's why we keep coming back to you again and again.
Because sometimes they message sometime in the night or like video, Hari, he khub chan kele, tumhi amala khub avadta hai. And that is like unexpected. I think that's really nice of you also to take that time out and message. I think it's very important.
It's a natural emotion which comes. So many times I keep telling her, it's so textural also, the house. Apart from the emotions, it's so textural, and we feel this overwhelming feeling many times, and we keep thanking you. So thanks, and that's why we are coming back to you with other projects also. Soon we'll be launching a very interesting concept for the design fraternity which they are designing. We'll be announcing soon. So thank you so much for this wonderful presentation.
Thank you, sir.
And answering our questions.
Patiently listening to us.
Please be seated. Now, for the final session of today evening, we'll be having a Q&A session, question answer session between the audience and Hari sir and Omkar and Poonam. Yeah, Uday sir.
As Hari Agashi sir so told in his interview that he had designed one bungalow, and in the later stage the client came and he came along with a vastu consultant, and he asked to change the staircase or anything. How did you convince him that you should continue with the same design?
Luckily what happened, his another friend was accompanying him. He is also, he strongly believes in Vastu, and we are renovating his bungalow. Luckily that bungalow has a staircase which was exactly what I had designed for that other person. Then he showed him that, look, even in my house the staircases are centrally located. So then he got convinced. So on the contrary, my problem got automatically solved, but I was ready to give up that job, because had it been so, he would have been insisted that no, I want staircase on this particular, today I would have said okay, bye bye.
Adding to sirs, I know he is not very adamant about not following Vastu. Also not very adamant of completely getting influenced by it. We try to go midway because there is no point of disappointing the client entirely. And that's what we take the middle path. We follow certain rules in our office because at the end of the day, if you are designing something, the client is bound to take the design to a Vastu consultant. Just yesterday I was telling him, every time if a new client comes to us, we'll ask them to first go to the Vastu consultant and bring the this thing, and then we'll be in the position to say, oh, this is wrong and that is wrong, which I think the Vastu people or the
maybe,
experts take
maybe
that will
reduce the unpleasant situations.
No,
there's
no point of doing the entire design again.
I am not at all against Vastu. I respect their thinking, because whatever, and every client is, it's all what they want. So I am definitely not against Vastu, but if their suggestions and their whatever additions and alterations are going to create problem, which I feel that suppose this is going to create problem later on, this is not a planning. So that is where I'll give up. But I respect their views and everybody. So today I like somebody, tomorrow he likes somebody. So it's everybody's choice. And freedom of, again, expression. This I want Vastu based. That's fine. I remember in one of Mr. Premnath architect's presentation, he said if the client asks me that design should be based on Vastu, I charge 5% more. I should follow that also rule now.
My question is to all of you. Do you have any Pinterest moments when your clients approach you?
So the clients bring Pinterest or we look
the clients?
This particular client.
You entertain them at a certain level and then or you all go with their designs and like, how is it?
I think Pinterest is a guideline actually. Because if client is not in the position to express or explain what he wants, and with the help of Pinterest, if we can explain that this is what I am visualizing my bedroom or drawing room, that's like having interaction with the client. And this is another medium. With Pinterest, you get the correct idea of client. You are not supposed to copy that. But at least what client wants, you get a clear idea.
But do you want to say that clients sometimes are irritating and they want exactly that which is not practical?
How do you convince? Because see, what's happening is they come up with all these online designs and everything. So that time in order to satisfy them, do you go again with their designs of what exactly they have shown?
Luckily, that has not happened yet. I don't know about tomorrow. If that happens, I still don't know how I am going to react.
Yeah, Shebanti Chakraborty wanted to ask a question.
Me too.
Yeah.
No, you'll do
it. Poonam and Omkar, how do you divide your responsibilities? And Amitji and Monika ji have different likings. When you are working on one particular design, do you come up with conflicts on how you want or how you want? How do you tackle that? Of course, arguments are always healthy and they lead to a better outcome. So how do you both deal with that?
We fight a lot. I think it's very important, and because both of us are architects, we've graduated from the same college, we've done our masters in different fields. So both of us have a very strong sort of perception also as to what we can deliver. But I think the base values, as Hari sir has mentioned, we are very similar, the both of us. So design styles might be separate, but we know that the end goal for the client, what will be best for the client, is what we both always try to achieve.
How do you divide your responsibilities, like room wise or till concept stage one works?
Earlier when we were in our struggling phase, we still are, I think everyone is, but with number of projects which were quite less that time, we used to divide responsibilities and it never used to work because I'm more into detailing, she's more concept driven. She's more into creating palettes and I'm more into, you know, creating, you know, where the hinges would fit and, you know, all the practical aspects of. So a lot of times we used to have a lot of fights because she being from a digital architecture field, she incorporates that and then she used to tell me ki aata hai banwayche. And it used to be very difficult to, you know, create that. But eventually as the project started growing, we have now come up with a solution that she handles a few projects and I handle a few projects and we just go to each other for feedback during the progress of the work. So that's we have resolved a lot of our issues that way.
I think for Amit sir and Monica ma'am's project in particular, we had divided the spaces. So who would design what? Not like initially, but we worked on a few concepts individually, and then we decided that yeah, you know, you can go ahead designing this, and you can go ahead designing that.
Thanks.
Somebody else wanted to ask. Yeah, Kaushik.
Yeah, just to follow up on the convincing, I think Hari sir has already reached that stage where he doesn't need to convince the clients. And I think the clients have a fair idea of how he is, and I think we all aspire to be at that stage where the clients already know what our background is, and you know, we try to do what we do best. So always up for that. And my question would be that as designers, when you design apartments, how relevant do you think it is to consider whether you yourself can live in that space? Because sometimes, you know, there are insane designs, and I look at work of a lot of architects and designers, and I feel, I mean, you are delivering something, but you know, you yourself can't really live in that space. So how important is that point while designing apartments?
Kaushik, very valid question. But if I have to design whatever apartment, and with my own ideas, as if that is my place where I am going to stay, then all apartments will start looking similar, because my ideas will keep on coming in every apartment. So that should not be the thinking. Try to be different, but which will convince your ideas, so that every apartment will give a different look, different impression, and again amalgamation of your own ideas and clients' requirements. So this is how one should go ahead.
I think there are two aspects to this. One is visual and one is the functionality part. So I think when it comes to functionality, I would prefer to be it on office or anything, where I can see myself moving in and out very comfortably. And that is, I think that is something which everyone follows at the back of their mind. But when it comes to visuals, that is something entirely up to the client. We never try to force our vision on any of the clients. It's always from the feedback. I think visuals is something I think we can always try to reach where it is irrelevant whether you can stay in that space or not. So of course, not going very overboard with it, but I think that is my answer for your question.
Priyanka wanted to ask a question.
जेव्हा तुम्ही डिझाईन करायला घेतलं आणि अमितजी आणि मोनिकानी तुम्हाला सांगितलं की हे अपार्टमेंट आहे आणि तुम्हाला ते डिझाईन करायचं, तर ऍज अ डिझायनर आपण जेव्हा एंटर करतो घरात तेव्हा आपल्याला डोळे बंद केल्यावर आपल्याला दिसतं की यस, आपल्याला हे असं डिझाईन करायचं आहे, तर तुम्हाला पण त्यात जाणवलं असेल. आणि मटेरियल सिलेक्शनच्या वेळेस आपल्याला पण इमॅजिन होतं की आपण यस हे असं असं करू शकतो, पण जेव्हा तुम्हाला मटेरियल डिफाईन झाले की या मटेरियल मध्येच तुम्हाला काम करायचं, तर काही रिस्ट्रिक्शन्स आलेत का की मनात असंच वाटलं का की नाही नाही ह्याच्यात नाही करू शकत, किंवा कन्व्हिन्स करायला थोडा त्रास झाला, जसं लॅमिनेट्स आणि व्हिनियरचं झालं तसं आणखीन काही जाणवलं का?
आय थिंक वन गुड पॉइंट अबाउट द वे वी प्रॅक्टिस अँड ऑल्सो विथ अमित सर अँड मोनिका मॅम ॲज क्लायंट्स इज वेन सॉर्ट ऑफ वी अलाइन्ड आर परसेप्शन्स की काय एक्सपेक्टेशन्स आहेत आणि आपण काय डिलिव्हर करू शकतो. We work a lot and very extensively on 3D views. So once they final झाले, त्या 3D view-च्या stage-लाच whatever feedback that they had, which was actually very minimal, but still whatever feedback they had, ते तिकडेच resolve झालं. So when we went in for selection, and that is always what we do, so when we go in for selections, we already know the client is also on the same page, ki this is how the visual output is going to be, this is the material we are going to select. आणि बजेट आधीपासूनच डिसाइडेड असेल तर यू ऑलरेडी नो व्हॉट मटेरियल यू आर गोइंग टू सिलेक्ट. सो आय थिंक तिकडे कॉन्फ्लिक्ट नाही झाला.
सो फर्स्टली थँक्यू सो मच हरी सर फॉर बीइंग सो जनरस मॅग्नेनिमस इन युअर अँड आय एम येट टू सी सो मॉडेस्ट a person who has achieved so much yet so modest. Omkar, thank you so much. Poonam, on both counts, for the wonderful home and the presentation. Thank you so much.